All right, I got it. Welcome to the Straight Red Cod. That's how Bob Dylan
was. I was about to say, was that Bob Dylan?
Yeah, that was nice. My Bob Dylan. Ooh. I can actually do it pretty good. But yeah.
Big question is why? Why would you want to do it really good?
Every once in a while, we would do a Bob Dylan cover with the band. And I just felt like, you know, I'm going to do it just like he does it. And why not? You know? So anyhow, yeah, I have a really good Bob Dylan impression.
We're Bob Dylan tribute band. My name is Rob Dylan.
I don't know if everybody's getting this, by the way. I've been listing Zimmerman as Bob Dylan because that's Bob Dylan's real name, Robert Zimmerman. So for Zimmerman, I've been listening since his name's so long. When I make the lineup sheets, sometimes I'll just call him Bob Dylan. Dude. So Bob Dylan Zimmerman, for those of you not
getting. I can't imagine that being that much shorter. Actually, I'm pretty sure that's probably just as long, if not a little bit longer.
Bob Dylan is a lot shorter than Robert Zimmerman.
Well, sure, or Walker Zimmerman. If you're going to spell out Walker Zimmerman, why don't you spell out Zimmerman or just abbreviate it to Zim?
I'm just going to do Dylan from now on. That makes it easy. You got, you know, Jedi, Dylan, Miles. Brother,
son, I mean.
Yeah. Oh, he did have a son who had, what are they, the wallpapers? The
wallflowers.
Flowers, wallpapers.
Hey, you're like 50% there.
I was close. All
one
right, yeah.
One headlight.
And then he had
like not a great impersonation, by the way.
No. He had like one hit, and that was kind of it. Maybe two. I don't know.
Yes, two, I believe.
A lot better.
One headlight and Sixth Avenue. Jesus, how did I pull that out of my ass,
dude? I don't know. Ow, but you must have been a big
no. I enjoyed it a little bit. I mean,
Jesus,
it was on the X. It was ready to roll. So,
all right, Einstein. Jesus Christ, pulling that shit out of your butthole. Oh, by the way,
I guess vodka and Crystal Light makes me smart. What can I say?
Crystal Light? Are you serious?
It's a cheap fucking mixer.
What are you, 60? Come on.
It's like pink lemonade with vodka, or any form of lemonade with vodka.
I do the lemonade and then the diet orange drink mixed. That's and weird. Then the vodka. Yeah, it's good.
Weird as fuck, man.
Speaking of pulling things out of your ass, Fox just hit me with a news because I got Fox. I've got all the major stations news. They pop up on my phone. I signed up for that somehow, and I'm not sure how. I'm going to have to unsign up for that.
Fox, huh?
Yeah, here's the headline. Man discovers tapeworm lived in his brain for years. Tapeworm in your brain? I thought that shit was in your butthole and your intestines.
Yeah, that seems to be an odd place for a tapeworm, but who am I to judge?
I mean, was it like feeding on his brain? Because the reason they live in your butthole is because they can eat the food and stuff, right?
For decades, they thought I was mentally handicapped.
But I mean, that's what tapeworm do, right? Yeah. They eat shit in your intestine and your whatever, and they're really long and disgusting. So, I mean, what do you eat on if you're living in a guy's brain? You must be eating his brain, right?
I mean, that's what I would think.
I haven't read the article. Sounds totally disgusting, though. I might have to read it after the show's over. I was titillated. See, they get me.
Report later.
Yeah, these headlines, man. And then I'm like, oh, fuck off. Some other guy died from some show years ago that no one remembers the dude, and he died today too. And the headline was, so-and-so, a star of this show and that show, died today. Star? I doubt it. All right, so let's get to this fucking game, Brett.
Let's talk about tapeworms and buttholes still. I think that's going to be much more interesting. Come on, guys.
You're right. The tapeworm is definitely trumping this game. This game, man, sucks.
I want to preface by saying I saw the lineup and I said, "Wow, way to go, Bob!" Or Bob, way to go, Greg. Greg. Yeah, I'm Bob now. Way to go, Mr. Dylan. Appreciate that.
Well, they're both. I mean, I thought you were getting Bob Bradley screwed.
No, they're both bald guys. Yeah. I go, way to go, Greg. Going for the win. That's awesome. And I went on. Like, oh, I feel the confidence. We're killing it after Mexico, so I'm going to place a big bet. I bet $20 on U.S. for the win. And, you know, we came into the game, and it was pretty sloppy. Pretty sloppy.
It was bad, dude. It was bad. Listen.
Not a great game.
That was a very poor game. And I just think generally, this is a general something that I've noticed in the away games is like there are certain guys that are given 100 out there. Mm-hmm. There's Aronson. There is Wea.
Yep.
Yedlin. There are a lot of guys busting. They're playing hard. Adams, mm-hmm. Zimmerman. Even Richards.
Let's also preface it by saying playing hard 100% or whatever doesn't necessarily mean that you have the cleanest game or don't make mistakes. You're busting your butt out there.
You could still be a spaz. But the problem is if you have three or four guys who are kind of like, yeah, I'll do with this. And then I'm going to do this. And I'll take my time getting over here and over there. I.e. Musa and Busio. Musa had some great stuff, but he also had a lot of bad passes today. Mm. And he just he looked too calm. And then Busio ran away from the play a lot of the time. He just didn't offer himself. He didn't want the ball. And I found that very weird. I thought he would have picked up some confidence playing for Venezia, but no, I guess not. He certainly wasn't fucking McKinney. That was the biggest missing piece.
No, because McKinney wasn't on the field. How could he be fucking him?
Yeah. You get what I'm saying. McKinney was like, he was the biggest missing piece tonight. It wasn't like Richards was a gigantic drop off from Miles Robinson. So that wasn't the issue. The issue was, where was the motor in the midfield? There was no motor. There was Musa on occasion, but he was so, like I said, sort of nonchalant with the ball. I said it like a French person. You know what I'm saying?
I 100% agree. My first note I wrote down for that first half was missing Weston, energy, and hungry for the ball. That's the big thing. Wherever the ball is at, McKinney wants it. And that's the biggest thing we were missing in that midfield. I thought Busio was almost playing too similar of a position to Adams, and Adams was like, well, Jesus, it's fucking congested in here. So he's starting to push up a little bit more, and I don't know.
They were almost like a double pivot sometimes.
It really was. It wasn't working. And I feel like if you play with like a Busio and an Adams again, either Berhalter has to go out there and say, hey, you know, Busio, get up in the attack, or play Adams and Busio back as almost like dual sixes, and then give us an actual number 10, somebody who's actually going to be a pivot up top that stays up top.
The problem with Busio is that he isn't really gifted in the final third. He had that one shot.
Hell of a shot, yeah.
But even with Venezia, it's not really his thing. Yes, he can do the eight roll. He can be competent at it. Mm-hmm. He can get the strikers the ball, but he's not like McKinney. He's not going to show up in the box at the very end of a cross and nail a header in. It's just not his thing yet. Maybe it will become his thing, but it hasn't been for club or country, nor for Kansas City when he was there either. Final third was what finally shifted him from a more attacking center midfield role back to a more sedated midfield role. And so that's just not his thing. I'm glad he got a shot tonight, but he didn't take it. He didn't shine.
He could, and looking at how he was playing today, and I know this is a small sample size, but maybe he fits more of a pure box to box, not necessarily an offensive minded midfielder or a purely defensive minded midfielder, just somebody that runs around in the midfield.
No, I get it.
I don't know.
I mean, listen,
how do you fit him in there? You know,
a box to box midfielder is expected on occasion to see the open gap and go make that run and score.
Maybe you'll pick that up. So,
yeah, he's going to have to watch more McKinney footage.
Sure.
And that might help him. He's not the physical specimen, though, that McKinney is. So he's going to have to work on that, too. He's still a little bit small and skinny. But that field was fucking horrible, man.
We joke around going in the CONCACAF like, oh, goat patch. And like we can't use it as an excuse, but man, it looked like they had like a par 3 course through that field and never replace the divots.
Yeah, I mean, it was ugly, and I'm sure that made for uncomfortable passing and uncomfortable, you know, quick passing, especially because you've got to know what you're kicking it at and to and through. So, you know, I get guys not being totally comfortable out there with that, but it is not really an excuse. I did not expect that bad of a field from Jamaica. And I don't even know why they would do it. They're the more, in a lot of positions, they're quicker, faster, and more physical. Why would you want a bad field when you can use your speed?
I mean, there's a reason why Jamaica went the purely direct game today. They went beelining straight down the pitch. They didn't possess around or do any ticky-tacky. Just quickly move it up the field as fast as possible, get it to your strikers. They'll head it down to one of the other people, and it was very direct ball. And and we tried some of that, but man, our center back pairing could not lace a long ball to save their life.
Which was unfortunate, since Zimmerman once again had such a good game. And I guess people were criticizing me for not giving him an A or a B plus last time. I'll just be honest, I didn't get to rewatch the film or the footage. So usually if I do, I'll go, oh, I missed that, and I'll fix it. But I didn't have time for it last show. But you're right, I watched the game a second time, and Zimmerman deserved an A last game. And really, I mean, out of all the defensive four, I mean, he was just everywhere, closing down holes, gaps, breakaways. I mean, Zimmerman was goddamn good. But,
I think he was solid in the defense. That's about the best way I can word it, because I think his progression forward, once he has the ball, unless he had time and space to move it, was just bad. I mean, it was bad, and he got under pressure, and he just hoofed it up there.
You can blame that on Zimmerman. Totally understandable. But I didn't see another – there was Adams, and when we had McKennie, there was McKennie too. And he made himself very available whenever Adams was, you know, marked. So – I didn't see that from Busio until later in the game. And even then I was like, well, what the fuck is Busio going back and getting the ball? And why is all of a sudden Adams playing, you know, one of the eight roles instead of the six? Yeah, it was weird to me. But maybe Greg just didn't think Busio could offer any offense. But if that's the case, why'd he play 90? So there's that too. You know,
in fairness, Adams isn't the offensive powerhouse either. He's a great distributor and moving the ball around type of player. But in the final third, he's not going to bag you goals or slot you assists either.
That's fine. But why do you take out Musa instead of Busio?
My fucking mind too. Yes, I understand.
I take out Busio. I don't take out Musa.
The thing is that at that point you bring in Acosta, and then all of a sudden you're left with three people in the midfield who have the same mentality of very much they're very much defensive oriented. I mean, Acosta isn't necessarily going to pick apart the defense either. He's going to break up plays and he's going to distribute the ball out. How many? But if you have three midfielders that are all going to do that, I mean, it's not, you're not going to have that much assistance into the attack. It's not going to happen.
How many goals has Adams playing the CDM role for Leipzig scored? Or how many assists does he have? Not many. No. They don't ask him to do that work. He's the connector that gets to the guy who gets it to the next guy who scores. Mm-hmm. So he's always left out of that equation. So, yeah, you got that guy. You got Busio, who is infamous for his lack of any, like, great last pass in the final third or even a shot in the final third.
Let's say he's got a hell of a rip when he takes it, but...
Yeah, I'm glad he took the shot. But and then you've got another guy, Acosta, also not known for scoring goals or setting up people for assists or as an assist. So, yeah, that was a bad move for me. That was one bad, you know, replacement, or as Greg likes to call it, solutions. Mm-hmm. You're a solution. You're a solution on the bench. Whatever, dude. Come on. You're on the bench, all right? Solution.
Well, somebody told him about that?
Yes, it was Gonzo.
Okay, and he's like, yeah, do this. And he's like, oh, yeah, people like that better than saying a sub or a bench warmer.
Gonzo brought that from Mexico. They should have just left it there frankly. A sub's a sub. All you want from a sub is a good 10, 15 minutes, 20 minutes if necessary. And the subs that were brought in, I don't think were the right ones. And we'll get into that further because Aronson was taken, was left on, and Weah was taken out. For Pulisic, I would have done the opposite. I would have kept Weah on and taken Aronson off. Aronson was pooped, dude.
Yeah, I was going to say, he's looking gassed.
Yeah, I don't take I don't think Weah, he did not look gassed. But Aronson looked gassed because Aronson busted it the whole fucking time he was out there. That dude never stopped high pressing.
And the previous match before that against Mexico, it was just he was always out there busting his ass. Yeah, I mean, if you're going to make the sub, and I guess he ended up subbing him regardless in the end. But yeah, that quickly, I would have taken out Aronson as well. And we've already talked about Acosta and as far as taking out Musa, why you wouldn't take out Busio instead. And nothing necessarily against Busio, but again, just back to our point, too many of like minds in the same area, you know?
Well, look, and how many of my notes say this? Busio, bad long pass. Mm-hmm. Busio, bad pass to Jedi. Busio, bad pass to Weah. I mean, listen, I got it. Busio, too tentative, doesn't get forward. Busio, double pivot with Adams? Really? Question mark. I mean, there's all kinds of things on here for Busio, and none of them are really positive. So, I don't know. It wasn't a great game for him. He got a chance, and he just didn't take it. I mean, he didn't shine, and he needed to shine. And then there was the one gal in studio, the former U.S. goalkeeper for the women. I can't remember. But she said it was like Groundhog Day. And she's right. It was like we have this great game, and then we have the usual peter off away game thing. And listen, you can't blame it on the field alone. You can't blame it on just any one particular player or the team or just Greg. Something is wrong here. The mentality is just off away.
I don't understand it, quite frankly, because we, again, at home, we're out guns blazing, passes are sharp, players are moving, energy's there, and then we go away, and then it's either spaz soccer or it's everybody's sitting on their hands, you know?
Yeah, and there was an element of spaz soccer. The biggest spaz on the field was Jedi. Yeah. Anthony Robinson would make these great little runs up the left, but his passing was just god-awful. At one point, he gunned like a 50-mile-per-hour ball straight at Aronson's chest. It's like, dude, just pass it to him on the fucking ground. But then it occurred to me when I watched a replay of the same pass that there Pepe was doing a thingy.
Was he trying to get to Pepe?
Yeah. I mean, it was just a horrible pass. There's no way it would have ever made it to Pepe.
Well, Aronson did a decent job on that, though.
Yeah, he did. And Aronson had some moments. Sure. But there's just something mentally off with the team. Like, they think that 1 point's good enough. Or when I looked at the way they interacted and passed together, my thought was nobody's sharp. Nobody's on their fucking game tonight. I mean, maybe Weah, Musa at moments, but then not in others. And yet, like Zimmerman, yes, but then no. Richards was nervous at times. And so nobody was really on their fucking game. And that's why this happened. I mean, nobody looked sharp. McKenny is the guy you can almost always count on to bring the positive energy, not the nervous energy, the positive energy, like the arrogant energy that you need. Yeah, that was just missing today. Just absolutely.
It was glaring. There. It was definitely glaring. Yeah. And it would definitely wasn't a like for like switch, but then again, I don't think any of our other options would have been like for like switches either. So that's kind of a disheartening thing to think about. If you really think like all it takes is one play and McKinney's out of the picture and then we're in this hole again, somebody has to step up in that midfield. And maybe it's Greg in the sense of saying, hey, you know, Busio, get the fuck up into the attack. Stop sitting back so far or whatever, you know?
Yeah. Yeah.
Something has to be different.
Yeah. We can't do this again. And I don't know if that's telling Busio to do this or that more, because he just seemed like a ghost for a long time. I mean, Adams was there and Musa was doing his thing on occasion and making sure the ball was moving forward. I mean, lost a lot.
I'm going to chalk this up as just a bad game for him, quite frankly, because he was surrounded by an A team. Mind you, the A team itself wasn't on firing on all cylinders either. But I'm chalking this up as a bad game. I'm looking forward to see what he can do moving forward. But obviously, West starting.
Yeah, no kidding. You know, I think it just felt like they got off the bus at the stadium, and there was a big Jamaican guy at the door to get into the stadium. And he said, okay, well, I have to punch you all in the face one time before this game, before you're allowed into the stadium. And they're like, okay, fuck it. And this guy just hauled off and punched everybody.
Fed him some bad jerk chicken.
Or bad weed. Yeah. Whatever it was, it just looked
jerk
bad.
Jerk chicken tastes funny.
I like jerk chicken.
I can hear my hair growing. No, I'm putting two and two together there.
No, that's for our foodie show, because I have a great recipe for jerk chicken Jamaican patties as well. So
yeah, me and my wife spent our honeymoon in Jamaica, and like every day just went down to this this grill right off the beach. He's constantly grilling jerk chicken and pork, jerk pork and everything like that. It was delicious as fuck.
No shit. Have you ever had a Jamaican patty?
Probably not.
Beef patty? Oh, fuck, dude.
No.
It's, and I got, now, okay. In my recipe, I replaced their dough with using phyllo dough. Yeah, I'm not fucking. I have all that meat in there and with all the spices and shit, but I wrap it in phyllo dough, about four layers of phyllo dough, and it's even better because it's all crispy and crackly and shit. Oh, it's delicious. If you haven't replaced your Jamaican patty recipe with phyllo dough, give it a shot. Cook the meat the same way, use all the spices, but pack in that fucking, use the phyllo dough. It is dope. It's like Greek meets Jamaican heaven. Boom. Delicious.
It's going to be your catchphrase instead of bam. It's boom.
Boom.
I have to bring it up because we didn't talk about it, but okay. The Jamaican goal.
Yes, speaking of Jamaicans.
Yeah. What?
And a fucking blistering patty. That was a hot patty, baby. That was a rocket.
Full circle, put a bow on it. Nicely done. looking at that goal, who would you blame on that goal? I mean, I feel like anytime there's a goal, there has to be somebody, a culprit, unless it's a phenomenal play. Adams, but who are you throwing in there?
Adams was a little relaxed, but then he was coming back and making a sharp cut, so he really couldn't get in front of him. Stefan didn't seem even remotely prepared to make a shuffle step, so I'm going to put that on Stefan. He didn't even make a shuffle step, because Stefan is a really great goalkeeper, and if his brain is turned on, he would have already made that shuffle step going, this guy's launching this shit, instead of going, is this guy going to launch this shit? Don't ask the question. Assume he is.
Recapping the play, Zimmerman went up on a 50-50 header with him, headed the ball back, and then he retreated back into the box. The ball got back to the goal scorer, and then Adams recovered. The cut occurred. He lost a little bit of ground and then didn't immediately pressure back up. But then again, who would have expected that rip? From right there. I mean, it's possible.
Stefan should.
But he should always be prepared for a shot. Absolutely.
Yeah,
and
I mean,
they talked about it in the halftime show about him being a little flat-footed and that he should have, you know, been on his toes and taken a couple small steps and then lunged for it.
Yeah, he should have shuffled. You know that. That fucking shit is a goalkeeper. And if that guy's going to rip it from there, you know it's going to be a left or righter. So, I mean, he's not shooting that short side. So that's going to be a left or right shot. You got to be ready.
He's in far post every time.
Yeah. I mean, he wasn't ready. He didn't see that shot coming. And knowing Antonio, they're both Premier League players, he should have known that Antonio will fucking rip one from there for sure. How'd you enjoy those Vuvuzelas? Annoyed. I fucking hated it. Turn them off.
I don't understand it. That's got to be annoying to the home players too, man. At some point, I'd be like, guys, can we cut it off of that shit? Let's come up with some chants.
So annoying.
We're Jamaica. We can do our own music. I couldn't, a whole history of music. Let's come up with something.
I couldn't get the sound of them out of my head, dude. It was just like, even after the game was over, I felt still, we're hearing ears them still in my ringing ears. Through it.
Like, oh my God. Weep,
weep. And the other thing, which was amazing to me, did you see how fat Moore was? That's a 30. I think he's 38 or something like that. He's a midfielder for, he doesn't even have a club, I don't believe. And he's still playing for Jamaica and he's 38. Mm. Did you see how fat, dude? That was a dad body. The guy was playing with a dad body. I was rooting for him. I was like, go, you go.
He makes
you
one spray, like huffing and puffing his leg. I'm like, I feel you, man. I feel you.
I was totally into that.
Oh,
I was
catch up on the next play, guys. God damn. Oh my God.
That was awesome. I also like how Cape Abdo was like, hey, Chelsea, Chelsea's not our problem. You know? Fuck Chelsea.
That's Dempsey's mentality, too. It's like, hey, we got, sometimes you just got to take that chance.
Yeah. I mean, Chelsea is not Greg's problem. It's not his problem to worry about. You do want not your player to get hurt.
Yes. God, that would have been, talking about broken English.
It's like Yoda shit there.
I think you were having like some kind of a stroke while talking there. Like that, you don't want hurt body, right? No,
it's not his problem, Chelsea. Greg Berhalter.
Ah, D-Rex, you coming back?
Oh, I know. But that, you know, it's kind of funny how close Yoda actually sounds to D-Rex. Yeah. So, all right, all the
pay the big bucks here at the Straight Red Card.
That's right. All the errant passes, taken into account here, and there were a lot of them. This team just didn't have. It just didn't have the
predominantly butter. Up that left side.
Yes. I mean, the butter wasn't melted for the bread, man. It wouldn't spread. And that's what happened tonight. So lots of things, lots of issues, crossing sucked. Set pieces sucked. I mean,
this entire window, the set pieces have sucked.
What is wrong with us? It used to be a strong thing for us.
I mean, and it's fascinating because You have Busio, and who was else? Was it Aronson taking it?
Aronson took some. Pulisic took some. They were all awful. It's just all of them.
It's just, I mean, these are players who should be able to lace the ball into that middle of that box perfectly, and just put it into a troubling spot.
But I could do it in high school.
We can't even get it over the first defender half the time.
I don't understand it. Like, if you practice your corners like I did in high school, and you took like 30 balls a day, which is what I did because I took the right corner kicks. And dude, if you don't figure out like the basics, like how to fucking make a corner kick to get it past the first goddamn guy, then you're broken. You need to be working on that more. Our set pieces suck. They suck. They're awful. And that has to be fixed.
And I guess something to consider, maybe they're trying to play it short for a slip header type thing instead of lace or putting it into the 6 PK area.
Right. But... Well, that's a good time to end this show.
Charlie, can you say hi?
Hi.
What's up, Charlie?
Derek says hi back. All right.
All right, Charlie. Until the next time on the Straight Red Card. Charlie's got to go back to bed. Yeah.